I'm at a very special place today, and I'm with a special person. I'm with Father Martin, who's actually the brewmaster, and tell us exactly where we are.
Oh, Judy, welcome to the Benedictine Brewery at Mount Angel Abbey, and we're here in the St. Michael Tap Room.
This is just an amazing place, and it's a history of monks and orders making beer, and you're kind of continuing that history. But first, we have to know about the Benedictine order, so if you can tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, it's the monastic order of the church, the oldest, you could say, organized monastic order in the Western Church. Christian monasticism arose in the 4th century. St. Benedict was a monk in the 5th, 6th century, Italian, and he wrote a rule that kind of organized the life in a way that was just became the standard in Western civilization. So a Benedictine motto is ora et labora, which is actually the way around, pray and work, two imperatives.
So really the Benedictines have a tie to the land, and if you could explain that.
St. Benedict's vision is really for manual labor. He says when monks live by the work of their hands, that's when they're really monks.
Ah, and so the beer making came out of that.
Yeah, really it did. Mm-hmm. Think back in the Dark Ages, after the fall of the Roman Empire, who kept structure in society? That fell to a large degree on the monks. So when it wasn't safe to travel, when you had no governance, the monasteries were areas where travelers could stay. But when you are the Motel 6 of the day, where do you stay?
Sure.
And when water sources get contaminated, there's no water treatment plants, people know that wine and beer are safe to drink, but water's often not. So the monks, having lots of guests and having their own needs for food and drink, brewing beer in regions where barley was plentiful and maybe grapes were not. You know, different
regions have
different things. So monks became known for their brewing.
So really, Mount Angel Abbey is in the perfect place here in Mount Angel because you are surrounded by agriculture. The order actually owns much of the land around here, so your hops are right across the street and you use these actually in your brewing.
We do. The tradition is there, and there are about 300 acres of hops grown on our land right now.
That is amazing.
And those are the ones we use in our own beer here.
That is cool. And then about how many different kinds do you brew here?
Well, on tap right now we've had 9 beers.
Wow.
And I've got recipes for I think 3 more that have not brewed yet.
This weekend is Oktoberfest here in Mount Angel, so where can we taste these beers? Because I'm sure they're going to be down at the festival.
Yes, we've had our beer here at Oktoberfest since we started making it. I think that's been about 6 years now with contract brewing. At Oktoberfest, our beer is available in the Hopfengarten.
Wonderful.
We were in the wine garden in the past, but this year they're moving us. It's a different venue, which features more craft beer, the higher quality beers, the little niche that they're trying to promote this year.
The Mount Angel Oktoberfest is a family-friendly event. You know, there is beer here, but you can come to the tap room. You can go to Oktoberfest. There's so many different things to do. There's delicious food. There's all kinds of crafts. And there's just so much fun, and the music is really wonderful. And the tap room is family friendly too. You can even bring the kids. Well, if you want to come out to the Oktoberfest to enjoy this special beer, go to the website to see the special hours at the tap room. But if you can't make it out for the Oktoberfest, please go to the website and find out all the information, how to get here, and then take a walk around the Abbey and then come down to the tap room to enjoy this special beer. Thank you so much, Father Martin.
Well, it's been my pleasure,
Thank
Judy.
You so
Thanks
much.
For coming.